tall, the average height of a male was found to be 1.75 meters, weighing 62 kilograms, and that of a female was found to be 1.57 meters, weighing 52 kilograms. The brain size of the Rhodesian man was calculated to be approximately between 1100 cubic centimeters to 1230 cubic centimeters. The reason it is also referred to as the African Neanderthal is because it demonstrates intermediate features between Homo sapiens and Homo neanderthalensis, with a close association to Homo heidelbergensis. The confusing part is, it has been argued that it was the ancestor of Homo sapiens idaltu, also known as the Herto man, which itself was the ancestor of Homo sapiens sapiens. The way of living and the environment at the time of their existence is not known, but some tools were found in an excavation 280 kilometers or about 170 miles away. Rhodesian man, or Homo rhodesiensis, adds to the existing evidence that humans came out of Africa. Instead of linear evolution, where one species replaces the previous one, Homo rhodesiensis shows that Africa was probably a melting pot of interbreeding human species, where Rhodesian man may have lived together alongside early Homo sapiens. For this reason, the Broken Hill skull is one of the treasures in the collections cared for by the Natural History Museum London. What are your thoughts on this? Let me know in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching, and for more related videos on human evolution, do check our channel out, as we have made tons just for you. Continue to give us your love and support by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel, and do let us know what content would you like to see from us. Till then, this is Halabella, and see you soon in our next video.